Okay, so very similar lineup. A Kopstal have tweaked things slightly. They've dropped the North Carolina for a Bismarck, and they have actually brought out a Z23 instead of the second Benson. Grief OMC rather has also switched his ship. He's got an Akizuki out, and we have a pair of Armagis as the battleship. So some minor but significant changes this time around. So switch over, get into the game. Group A, round two, OM versus Krupstahl.
Battle starts.
And as always, set up the suicidal carrier. So quickly launch those guys. And just for the sake of precision, these are in fact OMC, as we all should know. So, set up torpedo run one. Set up torpedo run two. Just extreme range, so all eight torpedoes hit. Then rearm group three. Once they make their drop, cue them to return. Ditto group four. Torpedo set one in the water. Group 4 committing, set to return. Okay, and while I'm in the business of committing suicide, let's pull out to the tactical map to see what we have got. And it's an early push by Krupstahl's aircraft this around. Torpedo bombers closing in fast, fighters closing as well, but they are running straight into the Akizuki's 10-centimeter guns, and well, one bomber gone, two bombers gone, three bombers gone, four bombers gone, torpedoes in the water. Grief slams on the brakes, torpedo beats over, and that is a bomber squadron gone for no avail. Woozy might be feeling that one a little. He hasn't got much in the way of strike power. That is an air superiority shokoku, very much standard for competitive play. He needs to be able to run air superiority and use his fighters as scouts. Dive bombers are in the air, but they've picked up the dive bombers from the Krupstahl's Shokoku as well. So Woozy now knows perfectly well that OMC have got bombers overhead and are scouting him. As a consequence, OMC now know the initial shakeout. To an extent, they know the battleships are running down to point A. They've got the capture progress indicator at in point A, telling them about an enemy destroyer there, and as a consequence, that smoke cloud, well, that's just a bit of a giveaway. And there we go, they got a quick glimpse of Greeno's 72 in the Benson. So they now have at least one of the enemy destroyers accounted for. The capturing point C, by contrast, could be the Charlie that they picked up over there. Whether this particular Charlie is going to be surfing, well, we'll see. That smoke cloud's a definite giveaway. However, Z23 or Seaweber are also present. And given the sheer size of that smoke cloud, yeah, that's the Z23, that's Steiner 58. However, the main action at the moment is back in point A, mutual exchange of torpedoes. Greeno 72 is diving back into the smoke. He's going to dodge the torpedoes himself, and he probably spotted them. So brace for torpedo beat. Chances are this salvo of 10 from The Legend Begins is just going to sail harmlessly through that smoke cloud, and beyond possibly a slight case of brown trousers, isn't actually going to hit anybody. Justellung has eaten some early shells. Nefex manages to squeak his bow out of the way of the torpedoes, and that is 10 Mark 14s gone to waste. As a consequence, OMC break away. They're not going to go for a stand-up slugfight, not with the main enemy battle line being at A, but the consequence of this is that they are conceding terrain. Krupstahl are now 2 points up to zero. Grief is just finishing up the capture of B, and he's smoked and hammering away on Charlie. Necroshadow goes down with elegant Leet DDK getting the kill, and just as they do that, they finally get a positive contact on Steiner 58. Steiner is not having any of it. He is not even trying to fight that much firepower. He is just turning and legging it, but he's got to break away from Flambas. And with his smoke launcher gone, the only way he's going to do that is if he can actually kill Flambas with his stern guns. Unfortunately, with the sheer amount of firepower he's got coming his way, that is not going to be enough guns or enough health. Steiner is probably doomed. He's on fire. Last volley's coming in. 200, 110, 0. Oh dear. Krupstahl is suddenly down a destroyer and a cruiser. Point C is now being capped by Flambas. So they are essentially unopposed. Again, Krupstahl have got this very similar situation to what they had in the first round. They have got the local advantage over here at point A, but they need to capitalize and get forwards quickly, or OMC are just going to regroup and throttle them from two sides. It also doesn't help that OMC know this very, very well because, well, we've got these dive bombers north of point A that are just happily providing reconnaissance information, especially on the battleships. Now, this could work for Krupstahl, of course. They've got German battleships with them, and if there is one battleship class and line in this game that it excels at bulldozing an enemy position, it is the German line. Of course, that does mean they have got to barrel straight into the teeth of OMC, and the longer they leave this, the worse it's going to get. Greeno 72 moves in, engages Grief, and that would have been a fair fight, vaguely, but it's not a fair fight because the rest of OMC's detachment from C opens up. Greeno 72 realizes just how badly he's outgunned, drops his smoke, turns away, but with the sheer amount of fire he's got coming at him, he is not going to last much longer, and he goes down. If the fire got him, but well, it was that or torpedoes or random shellfire. Krupstahl have lost both their destroyers. OMC have yet to lose a ship, although Grief is, I think, probably feeling the pinch a little since he's on less than half health. Krupstahl attempting now to push out of A. They've got to get south and east. They have got to start breaking some of these destroyers and getting the control points back. Unfortunately, they may have left it too late. We have Embraer, we have Zustalong, we have DD-47, but they are sailing right into the teeth of this delaying action, courtesy of The Legend Begins, Segador, and Absolute Dominance. Riding with Dominance second as the bombers come in, Flak gets one, two more coming in. Are they going to be able to neutralize this drop? Bombs come down, bombs miss completely, but bear in mind that Legend is still spotted, so he is diving for this Flak as fast as he can. Bombers pull away. He should be safe. He will be safe if he can reach the smoke cloud. Dives into the smoke. Rudder hard over to starboard to break contact. And as he survives and gets away, now here comes the main push. But the problem is that OMC have had enough time to get their ships back together. And as Krupstahl come away from point A, they are going to sail right into the teeth of this flank attack from point B by OMC, and Didi, I think, has just realized how much trouble he's in. He eats a torpedo. Embraer is following as best he can. He pops his smoke, but unless he slams on the brakes and turns right now, he's about to get his own explosive surprise. Oof, there's the torpedo beat, but he had to brake hard to do it, and OMC have a pretty good idea of exactly where he is. Firing back into his tracers, we saw some splashes, not necessarily any hits, but well, that's an Akizuki. It's firing several dozen rounds a minute, but it's the Kutuzov that gets the kill. Zustalon comes out, it's his turn to run. The gauntlet DD-47 is pushing in, but at this point, he's got to know he's doomed. He's on 13,000 health, 12,500. High explosive raining in, cannons in front of him, cannons to the left of him. Volleyed and thundered. Ce n'est pas la guerre, c'est folie. Especially when you've got that many guns pointed at you. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. DD-47 reenacting the final moments of the Bismarck there. Down he goes, which leaves Zustalong suddenly a very short of friends. And, well, this wasn't how the Tirpitz went down in history, but fair enough, apparently she's going to join her Onesimus in the grave. 6,000 health, 5.5, multiple fires burning, 3,000, 2,000, 1,500 gone. Question is, where are their cruisers, who are probably reconsidering their life choices right about now? OMC not in the mood. Radar is popping, and as a consequence, thanks to that and the final fading of the enemy's smoke, Nefex is now badly exposed. He's skittering out of his covering position where he was providing radar support, and he's temporarily managed to get out of sight, but, well, there's only really one way he can go here, and that's west and northwest. And you can see that Grief has turned northwest. He's going to probably either angle down this channel here or go a bit further north and come round here and get hard spotting on Nefex and Quebba, which, and at that point, it will basically be game over. Flambas rethinks, turns southwest. Quebba is broadside on, and now he's dead. That's one of the things about British light cruisers, of course. Yeah, they can be fragile. And, well, Nefex, I suppose, has the consolation that he is probably going to survive the match. OMC are on 989, 992. I don't think they're actually going to kill him before they run their points out. And, oh my word, 11 minutes. Well, 10 minutes and 35 seconds, if you're being picky. That was an utter demolition. OMC pull in a win on the match, and with that bye, that sends them through to the round of 16. Krupstahl have one victory and one loss. They have all to play for in their third match.